In this video, we're going to explore a sequence and determine whether it converges or diverges. So the example that we're going to be looking at will be the sequence, the nth term of the sequence determined by excuse me, n factorial divided by 2 raised to the nth power. So as you can see here, we cannot use the L'Hopital's rule directly or indirectly to determine the limit of the sequence. And we cannot use any known techniques for this. However, we can use the indirect proof. Okay, so indirect proof will be consist of two steps here, right? The first step will be to see whether this sequence is increasing or decreasing. So when it's increasing, so increasing sequence is such that one term of the sequence is greater than or equal to the preceding term. Okay? Now, decreasing sequence is such that one term is less than or equal to the preceding term. Okay? So that's the first part. And the second part in determining whether it converges or not is going to be by determining whether or not whether the sequence is bounded by a number m. Okay, and this m value has to be positive, okay, so it must be greater than zero. So if we determine that the sequence is increasing, that's just the first step, right? Because this increasing sequence may not necessarily diverge if it has a number m greater than zero that bounds it. Okay, I will show you graphically. So we can have a sequence increase and keep increasing as n goes to infinity, but there's a line here at some number m greater than zero that bounds it, that bounds the sequence, right? So this sequence will converge to it. Okay, so first let's determine whether it's increasing or decreasing. So to do that, we will need to divide one term of the sequence by the preceding term. Okay, if it's greater than 1, then most likely it's going to be increasing. If it's less than 1, it's going to be most likely decreasing. Okay, but let's test it. So we're going to substitute the a subscript n plus 1 for this given sequence here. So we're going to have n plus 1 factorial divided by 2 raised to the power of n plus 1 divided by the given n factorial divided by the 2 to the nth power. And that gives us n plus 1 factorial divided by the 2 raised to the power of n plus 1 multiplied by 2 raised to the power of n divided by n factorial. And that means that we will have n factorial multiplied by n plus 1, 2n, divided by 2n, okay, multiplied by 2, and multiplied by the n factorial. And that turns out to be, since we have some common terms to cancel out here, we have n plus 1 over 2. Now, n plus 1 over 2 is going to be greater than 1 for n greater than or equal to 2, right? Because when n is equal to 1, we will have 1 plus 1 over 2, which will equal 1. If n is equal to 2 or greater, it's going to be 2 plus 1 over 2, which is 3 over 2 or greater, right? Which is going to be greater than 1. But before we conclude that it's an increasing function, we have to multiply both sides of this inequality by a subscript n. Right, so we're going to have n plus 1 over 2 multiplied by the n subscript n is greater than a subscript n. So now let's substitute that, and we're going to have n plus 1 over 2 multiplied by n factorial over 2 raised to the power of n is greater than a n. Okay, and this gives us n plus 1 factorial divided by 2n plus 1, right? And that is equal to, as you should know, the a n plus 1 subscript, and that is greater than a n subscript, right? So that means this proves that it's actually a decreasing function, increasing function for all values of n. Okay, well, not for all values, but for values of n greater than or equal to 2. Okay, because as we showed earlier, it doesn't really matter if when n is equal to 1, it's the same. It doesn't matter, right? Because we're interested to see the end behavior of the sequence, how it behaves at the end, and not for the first few terms, for that matter. So we showed that it is indeed an increasing sequence. But now we have to show whether the sequence is bounded by a number m greater than 0, right? So whether or not this is what the graph suggests here, whether there is a line that will serve as a boundary. Because most likely, it has to be that the sequence will converge to that number, the line represented by this number, if indeed the sequence can be bounded by that number. Okay, so let's investigate that. So we're given that the sequence is determined by n factorial divided by 2 raised to the power of n. So we have to have an absolute value of the an, okay, and we have to see whether this absolute value of the sequence can be less than a number. Right, so as you know, the absolute value of this is going to be simply n factorial, because n will always be positive, and the 2 raised to the power of n will also be positive, right? So we might as well just get rid of it. So we're winding up at the original sequence we're given. But try to see that the only thing that you can actually think of that can be greater than this is going to be n factorial, right? Because you can't say n factorial divided by 2, and even if you were to divide by 2, first of all, it would be less, it would be greater. So, well, let's see. So n divided by the 2 would be greater. Yeah, it would be greater than this, right? So this is no good. We can't use that. Right, but even if we were to use it, how would we think of a number? How would we get rid of the n factorial there? That's problematic, right? So as you can see, if you want to found a boundary number m, you have to think of ways to get rid of the n somehow, right? And only remain with a number. But the only thing that you can think of here is that it's less than the n factorial. But n factorial is not a number, right? Because it's not a constant, right? You don't know what the n is. N can be anything. N can be infinity, right? So basically, you're thinking of that this function, this sequence is less than infinity. So if it's less than infinity, then infinity doesn't really tell you much, right? If you take this to the infinity. So that means that there's no way to bound this sequence, right? So we can say it's unbounded. So even though it's increasing, there's no boundary. So it just keeps increasing and increasing and increasing, and it never stops. So that means that it is actually divergent. Okay? So hope this tutorial was useful to you. Please subscribe and I'll see you in my next video.